tell you some of my memories of the Marquee is that I was very nearly a jazz fan, but not quite. Not, at least not in 1958. If I can get up to London, because I lived in the West Country, and if I could get up to London, that maybe someone would discover me and make me a star. Unfortunately, it didn't quite happen that way. But I did play on the stage of the Marquee, and I had to wait until about 1966 or 1967 to get there. But my memory of the Marquee was it was exactly the same as we've seen it over the last however long. Full of screaming girls, like the girls you hate that scream after Duran Duran. And I got pulled off stage, I had my shirt ripped off my back. And for me, it was just fantastic. I'd also like to say, it's a great way to travel.
Do you think I could have one for Christmas?
I don't know, but I'll have a word with your dad. Who we're going to meet now is a guy who I've known for 19 years. He's been a friend for 19 years. He was the drummer with the Small Faces. Remember the Small Faces? He then was the drummer with Rod Stewart and the Faces.
I know Rod Stewart.
You know Rod Stewart.
Yeah.
And now he's the drummer with The Who. Can you hear the drums?
Yeah.
Come on, let's go and meet Kenny Jones. Kenny!
Well, yes, go.
Come and have a seat.
With you in a
come
minute.
And have a seat.
Thank you very much, Captain.
Karina,
hi,
Kenny
Karina.
Jones,
nice to meet
Kenny Jones, Karina. Kenny, we've been spending a little bit of time doing a documentary on the 25 years at the Marquee. So first of all, can I ask you what the Marquee meant, if anything, to you?
A lot of great memories, and to this day, it's very consistent. It's still there.
But it wasn't just the Marquee, there was a whole scene going on in the 60s.
Yeah, I mean in that era.
The whole thing about the early 60s was that it wasn't just music, it was the clothes. I mean...
Yeah, that's what I like about what's
I'm trying to think
today,
about the clothes that you used to wear and the way that we all sort of backcombed our hair the old hair lacquer.
Yeah. One of the funniest things about Carnaby Street, with talking about fashion in those days, was... we had a gig up north in Birmingham or somewhere, and the Small Faces got some time off to buy some clothes in Carnaby Street. So we all went our different ways. And we all came back together to meet, to get into the car to go up to Birmingham. And I came out with Lord John's with a check shirt on, with a check tie, check jacket, check trousers and check shoes. And they all ran away from me and got in the car and just went... I look like Coco the Clown, you know. I thought I was being
trendy.
Mod.
For me,
yeah.
It was a whole heap of fun. I mean, I'd just give one example of what I now look upon with affection as fun. There was a guy called Chaz Chandler, who we both know, who was the bass player with the Animals.
Yeah.
And being a Geordie, he said, "Ia Delia." He said, "I got this Greek guitarist," he said, "from America." He said, "I've just made this record. I can't do the Geordie accent anyway." He said, "He's great, man."
Yeah.
He said, "I've just made a record," and he played me an acetate by this guy called Jimi Hendrix, and it was "Hey Joe." It was the Tim Rose song,
right?
Right. And I mean, if you think that if that was the beginning of Jimi Hendrix, he said, and apart from that, man, he said, he plays it with his teeth and his feet as well. And I listened to this record of "Hey Joe," and I thought, Jesus. And that was when I decided that I didn't want to be a pop star anymore.